Hey, it's MK, and I am back with 31 Days of Cut File Fun. And this week, we are featuring Pear Tree Cut Files. Now, this is a UK company over in, over in the UK, obviously. And this one, the theme for this month is backgrounds. So all of these cut files will have the full coverage page going on for the background. Now, this little airplane file, when I first cut it, I thought, what pieces do I keep? Because I'm kind of a little confused. I thought I was going to have to keep every single one of those tiny little pieces that cut out. And so I called Christina and she goes, oh, no. You keep the background and you throw all those little bits away, but you keep the little airplanes. And I was like, that just does not make any sense. So let's see what I can do with this cut file. In the meantime, I picked out this legendary kit that I am ashamed it hasn't even been opened, you guys. This is exactly how I ordered it, exactly how it came in the mail, minus the packaging of the box, by the way. And yeah, how embarrassing is that? So let's open it and see what I have in here. Now, I already know what I have in here. I've seen the legendary kit. I've just never touched my own. How embarrassing. I also picked out a couple of, I believe those are photoplay, little thicker cameras, and then a Heidi Swap title, wood veneer, and then the Not Just for Boys Kit Club arrows. So in this kit came some flair, some really cool titles. These are rub-ons right here. I also have a die cut pack, which this is my second one. I'm still working through the very first one, so I probably won't open this one. Or maybe I do. I'm not sure. I probably do, so that way I don't have to get off my seat. And then I have these enamel dots. Yay! I love enamel dots, you guys. And this paper collection. Now, I'm not going to flip through every single piece because I actually do that when I try to figure out how I'm going to back this cut file or what I'm going to do for my paper choices. But it comes with this little 6x12 sticker sheet as well. So that's kind of fun. All right. So moving on to the layout, I have decided that I am going to cut out. Yes. Cut out all of these little things. Now, maybe that's not how it's supposed to be used, but my brain could not fathom any other way of doing this. So I'm going to take a few minutes to fussy cut this. Then I'm going to take a few minutes to choose the paper. I need one for my background, what to put the file on. And this whole time in my brain, I'm thinking this needs to be black. This cut file needs to be black. Yes, it looks good white. I definitely want the airplanes to be white because it just reminds me of paper. But the little entrails or the little dashes and dots definitely need to be black, and I don't know why. So I struggle a lot in trying to figure out what papers, because I really don't want to use this gorgeous rainbow paper. Not that I have any other excuse to use rainbows, because I clearly don't scrapbook rainbows. But I just can't figure out what else to use. And I have a confession to make that in the time frame of me making this decision, I turn the camera off, make the entire layout, and completely forget to turn the camera back on. Yep, there it is. This is what I get for trying to work ahead, is I just get so distracted in creating a layout that bam, there it is, all done. Yay! So I did pull out a few of the die cuts. All of the stars for the die cuts, used one of the arrows and a flare from the Not Just for Boys Kit Club and the flare from the Legendary Collection. And honestly, you guys, that's it. I did back, so I did end up spraying this cut file with black Altenew spray ink. And then I backed the cut file with just some solid pieces that I already had scraps left over from another boy collection from Coco Vanilla. And then, of course, I did cut into that rainbow stripe. I just didn't really see any other way of wanting to do it that way. And I popped those airplanes up on foam so that way they kind of stuck out, but I also kind of cattywampused them a little bit so that way you could see the background of the other ones, but I really didn't want them to be straight on with the other cut file. Anyways, I apologize about the entire process being gone, but literally it was just me picking out the elements that I was going to use and then gluing them on the paper. I mean, this cut file made it uber super simple where things were going to go, and then just basically decorate around it. That's it. So I apologize that there was no process. This was all that I had. It's so embarrassing. I will try not to do that the rest of the month, because clearly it's becoming a habit. All right. Thank you so very much, and I will check y'all later. Bye.